Sree Iyer come in here, do you share Shantanu Sen's assessment of this entire case? Because fact of the matter is that there is no extradition treaty between India and Antigua. However, that country, of course, does have a law which provides for extradition of a fugitive to a designated Commonwealth country. But at the end of the day, if it boils down to whether the government of Antigua wants to extradite him or not, what, according to you, are the odds that we are going to see this fugitive finally face the Indian law?
I think he is going to be brought back to India. I compliment the Lodi government for the perseverance. The reason is that Antigua is a very small island. It forms part of what we call as West Indies. And for them, you know, this is probably not giving the right kind of messaging for high net worth individuals who might want to park their money there or might want to take citizenship there. So they may want to try and make it look like they are a law-abiding country, that they follow the international laws. And I think you're going to see him come back in. Neha, if you will just permit me a second. Mehul Choksi has layers of crimes that he needs to answer for. The one that we all know about is the Punjab National Bank scam, but there are other things also. For instance, there were a series of raids conducted on the showrooms, and
that's right,
there was a list prepared. In this list, what happened was a lot of high net worth individuals had paid, had paid some of their money in white and some in black. And this data was, you know, detailed in a tabular form. What had happened was some rogue journalists got hold of this, and they were actually calling up these HNIs and then telling them that your name is here. If you don't pay up, you know, we are going to, you know, you're going to be acted upon.
Right.
So there is they have really, you know, ruffled the feathers of many people. And that's just one more. There's also questions about the problems that some of his franchises might be facing. Evidently, what has happened is many of the franchises did not get what they were promised when they opened their show.
All right.
Everybody saw
it. All right. Mr. But I want Sree Iyer to wrap up this debate for us.
Happen.
Okay, Sree Iyer.
But the political decision is final.
Okay, I take your point, sir, that ultimately it is probably a political decision that rests with the governments of, you know, these various countries. However, Sree Iyer, you know, do we not need to sound a note of caution here? Because while we have got a favorable order already from a UK court, fact of the matter is it's still a long road ahead. It's still a long legal process, with Vijay Mallya obviously determined to exhaust all his legal options. So it may still be a while, or perhaps a long, long time, before we see any of these men coming back to India.
That is correct. You cannot rush this process. They have to be given the due process of law to state their case. And, you know, if it takes a few more months, so be it. My take on this is that there could be some surprise. For example, between Mehul Choksi and Nirav Modi, Mehul Choksi was the kingmaker. So I think that is a bigger catch, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. Also, we don't know if he has some other, you know, citizenships also. Many countries allow multiple citizenships. What if he were to, like, for example, go and take a residence in Malta? Malta doesn't have extradition treaty with anybody.
Right.
You see, so I'm just saying that there could be more surprises down the road. When somebody knows that they are committing a crime, they may try to have plan A, plan B, plan C, and plan D. But be that as it may, I commend the government for its dogged persistence of going after these people and for trying their best to bring them back.
But let me bring in Sree Iyer on this. Sree Iyer, isn't that the problem here? The Congress party will keep shouting Rafale scam from the rooftops. The BJP will keep milking Agusta Westland. This is election season, and
no,
therefore,
the
and therefore
FIR.
We will
we
see these political
the
attacks.
We registered
but
the
at
FIR.
The end of the day, isn't it about what is proven in a court of law? And that
they
needs to be backed by solid
FIR
evidence.
Defend.
Okay, come
no,
on,
Neha,
Suleiman, don't shout me down, don't
facts.
Be unfair.
No,
you had your say.
No,
you
no,
had
I'm
your say. No, my question is to Sree Iyer. Mr. Iyer, at the end of the day, isn't it about what is proven in a court of law? Or is this only about public perception in election season? Sree Iyer.
In my opinion, there are compelling facts that have prompted the government to take this action of extraditing Choksi and Michel and bringing him back into India. There are many, many pointers that show that there is more than money trail, but they've also traced the thing. The ED or the CBI may not be revealing all their cards. And why should they? Why should they? Remember, Mr. Chidambaram had actually pulled out 12 pages from a report because he didn't like what the Home Ministry had written. And there are many instances like this where this particular person, by the way, he should be the last person talking about anything on this matter. If I were Congress, I would not allow him to make any statement, but that's just my opinion. There are several instances where this kind of thing has happened.
These false cases and political vendetta
are going to be against the government. Come on, we need this quiet. Vineet is quiet. Come on. So you should not be shouting others down either. Okay, Mr. Iyer, complete your point.
And vendetta against our leaders.
Okay, Suleiman, you had your say. Okay, Mr. Iyer, please quickly finish your point.
Yes. I'll give you one other instance. You know, who was the Comptroller and Auditor General in 2013 appointed by UPA? The person who worked on the Agusta Wetland case, Shashi Kant Sharma. He was a DG.
Sir, I'm sorry, but we really don't have the time to go back into the history of the case. We need to keep our focus on what's before us. Okay.
They're trying to cover
Let me go back to Shantanu Sen, who